I'm going to show how I create and navigate a monthly calendar in VB.net. I have 8 panels to use as containers for sizing. The first function is size containers that will set size based on the client. I'll call the function during the initial load and when the client size changes. Run it. And you can see the containers resizing. Next, I create the month name and year label and add it to the first container. Then size it by using the controls find method to locate the label by name, then center it inside the container. Make calls to these functions. Run it. Next is creating labels for days of the week. I'll size the labels by sending the container to a function. The sizing function is setting each child control to an equal width. Make calls to these functions. Run it. Next, I'll create calendar days. I'm creating a panel for each day and adding the day of the month label to the panel. The naming pattern I'm using is the row and column so that I can find specific days. Then add the panel to the correct container. I can reuse the sizing function. Add call to these functions. Run it. And days are added. Now I'll create a class called Monthly Calendar Info to help populate the calendar. I'll add members to store the month, year, and days. The month and year will be accessible through properties. The default constructor initializes to the current month and calls set days. The second constructor accepts year and month if they are valid. Set days is finding the first date in the grid, then looping and setting each day. For example, if September 1st is on a Wednesday, I subtract 3 days, which will be August 29th, then loop and add 1 day. If the minimum year and month is expected, the logic would need to account for that. The goToMonth method moves to a new month. Day and month returns the day for the row and column passed. IsActiveMonth checks if the row and column month is equal to the month member. IsToday checks if the row and column is equal to the day's date. Row returns the row equal to the past date. Call does the same thing for column. And DataZix checks if the past date is in the current calendar grid. Now back on Form 1, I'll create a calendar info object. Initialize it to September 2021. And call populate calendar. In the populate calendar function, I'm setting the month name and year. And setting the days of the month text and color. Run it, and the calendar days are populated for September. Now I add events to specific days. Add a function called createTestData. I'll create a list of dates and text to display. Then I'll find the panel for the event date and add a label to it. Add a call to this function. Run it. And you can see the event labels added. The last thing is to navigate to different months. I'll use the panel click event to do that. If the click is on the left side, I'll go to the previous month. Otherwise, I'll go to the next month. I'll also call a function to remove old events, call populate calendar, and call create test data. The remove test data function uses recursion to remove all test labels. Run it. And I can navigate the calendar.